situation on the Korean Peninsula.
Nobody thought about it. Here, all right.
And you're going to interfere with that? That's why the founding fathers created this immunity from prosecution and subpoena. Now, if it's a civil case, Clinton submitted because it was a civil case.
Why not written answers to a proffer?
Which Ronald Reagan did.
Why not that?
Because they said no to that. They said no to that. And
so the president says no to the interview, then they're going to what?
At this point, I'm not sure I'd give them written answers because they're going to try to contradict them. I believe that Attorney General Sessions, my good friend, and Rosenstein, who I don't know, I believe they should, in the interest of justice, end this investigation. There's been too much government misconduct. The crimes now have all been committed by the government and their agents. The lies by Comey.
I'm going to go through this in a minute. Let me ask you this.
It's terrible.
What are the parameters that you would insist on for any interview with Mueller beyond 2 to 3 hours, narrowing the scope?
Never beyond 2 or 3 hours. I'm not going to have my client, my president, my friend, and a president who's achieved more in a year and a half against all odds than anyone had a right to expect. I'm not going to let him be treated worse than Bill Clinton, who definitely was a liar under oath. I'm not going to let him be, he's being treated much worse than Hillary Clinton, who had no right to any of that stuff. So I'm not going to let him be treated worse than Hillary Clinton. I think Jay and I will insist that they're going to have to treat him the same way as Clinton. 2.5 hours, we end, we walk out. Give us your questions in advance. He's ready to...
I know him. I've interviewed him. I've known him for many years before he ran.
And if we weren't careful lawyers, we just let him go. I mean, he's about the most...